There's a look at a capacity crowd that's been anxiously awaiting the start of this one. It's game four of the American League Division Series between the Toronto Blue Jays and the Seattle Mariners. Hi again, everyone. Matt Vasgersian. Welcome to our special postseason coverage of Baseball on the Show. With me are Eric Karros and Steve Lyons. And Steve, lots of storylines here as we approach the start of Game 4.
And remember now, this is only a five-game series, so this is an elimination game. And I think that anytime a team's season is on the line, well, they've got to play with a sense of urgency. So I think that's exactly what we're going to see here.
The postseason is officially in full swing. Lineups and first pitch coming up next. Back now as we draw ever closer to first pitch, let's listen in to public address announcer Mike Carlucci.
And now your 2016 Seattle Mariners.
Briefly here, a glance at the two starters who'll get the ball here in this one. With that, a look at John Gibbons' lineup for the visiting Blue Jays. Anybody catch your eye, Eric?
Well, there's only a few guys that can swing it and flip it like Joey Bats, Jose Bautista.
And he's a home run threat every time he steps into the box. If they want to shut him down, they're going to have to be careful and keep the ball low in the zone. Don't give him anything he can drive.
Nate Carnes will do his best on the mound to keep his team alive here in the division series. EK, what's the word on him?
Well, guys, he's been what you would call a fourth or fifth starter. Got a career ERA of over four, but he will give you innings, and he is dependable.
And with a quick breather here, let's take a look at how the Mariners will set up defensively. It's brought to us by Majestic. Eric?
Well, guys, Kyle Seager over at third base, one of the best all-around third basemen in the game. Remember, he was an all-star in 2014.
Edwin Encarnacion gets his first opportunity now in the top of the first with nobody on. Infield in the overshift here, now the pitch. They'll try and entice him with a high fastball, but he wouldn't commit. It's ball one. You got to figure that that man right there would be more than happy to see this guy at the plate taking his swings with two out and nobody on all night long.
So would the guy on the mound.
And this one is gone. A home run. So a solo home run for Edwin Encarnacion. His first homer here in the series. As the Jays get the game's first tally, it's 1-0.
This is what you expect when you make it to the postseason. I mean, you expect the guys that have carried you all year to keep on producing, and sure enough, he comes through again and delivers a no-doubter here.
And now a quick look at the Mariners' starting lineup in this one. Steve, what are they going to rely on as they try to win this one and stay alive?
Well, facing a knuckleballer, that just gets so difficult. There's two theories. Either swing at the first one or don't ever swing. But these guys, they can put you in a slump for about a week.
R.A. Dickey will be on the mound for Game 4. What's your take on him, EK?
Remember, guys, this is someone that will come at you with four different pitches. He'll change velocity, he'll go up and down, the break on the pitches makes it a real challenge for a hitter.
And with that, let's give you a look at the defensive alignment for the Blue Jays. It's brought to us by Majestic. Eric, what do we need to know?
Well, guys, this manager loves
one away in foul territory, and there are two men out. And with two gone now, let's take a look at our up-to-the-minute playoff tree. And as you can see, the winner of this series will battle the Angels to decide who'll be the American League's representative in this year's World Series. Again, the side is retired. Kevin Pillar will stand in, and you see the numbers for the series so far. He's really been one of their...
Just off the plate enough to make him offer, but not good enough that he can do anything with it.
Settling in now, Deionor Navarro, as the switch hitter will take his cuts left-handed here.
And he's not quite as powerful from the left side as he is batting right-handed, so he just doesn't quite have that same pop in his bat batting lefty.
And he's back easily.
Keeping him close.
First offering on its way. Pitches a cold strike. The throw. It bounces, but he's out. Nice play there to pick the throw and put the tag now. Devin Travis into the box here in the top of the second, looking to keep this inning going. Now he swings and golfs this one into left center. It's going to work out for him as a base hit. Melvin Upton Jr. set to take his first cuts with a man at first and two away.
Yeah, and he's going to have to find a gap.
In the dirt here. And he'll make it into scoring position here with two away, as that'll be scored a wild pitch.
Location on 0-2. The last thing you want to do is hit him.
Hit hard towards center. And that's in there. Base hit. Around third and being waved on home. The run scores from second. It's a 2-0 ball game. And time will be called here as the pitching coach heads out to the mound and hopefully try and settle this guy down a bit.
And it's got to be frustrating to be a power hitter like he is and play 81 games in a pitcher's park like this one. I mean, guys are motivated by numbers, and you just wonder what he could be doing in a ballpark that better suits his swing.
Chop foul at the plate, strike one. Right side and right into the shift, and that's through for a hit. Troy Tulowitzki is into the box as we are all set to begin the third.
And they jumped out to that early lead, so now it's all about just
own here early on.
And that's not the worst thing in the world at this place, but you've got to pick your spots.
Oh, and that's knocked down. And some problems defensively as they allow him to reach first safely. So that'll go into the book, but it never really had much of a shot. And I'd be surprised if that's not an infield single. Coming to the plate. They really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out.
You want to talk about throwing a fastball in a guy's kitchen? He came in, sat down, had a cup of coffee with him. You aren't going to tie a guy up any better than that.
Here's Leonis Martin as he'll watch a knuckleball that dances its way in there for strike one.
Pretty good speed here coming out of that left-handed batter's box, so it's no sure thing that a ground ball means a double play.
Hit hard on the ground towards second. Tulowitzki for one. On the smoke, it's a double play, and that'll end the inning. 4-6-3. They roll it up to get out of the jam. Game four rolls along. We're back after this. The right fielder's grasp as he ranges over to handle it for the first out. Standing in, Justin Smoke will trying to strike him out for the second time. And that is swung on and missed. He's down on strike. Leading off the inning, Ketel Marte, as they'll look to get something going here and even. Got him. Dropped by the catcher, though. Navarro is after it. So not the start to the inning he was looking for as he got the strikeout, but the runner reaches anyway. Digging in, Robinson Cano. He got on top of one and was a ground-out victim last time.
Now you got to beware of that sinker. I mean, he'd take a strikeout right now, but I think he still just wants this guy to hit the ball on the ground.
And here's a swing and a miss by Cano as he sat down on strikes, and there's one away.
Well, you never know. This might have been the lesser of two evils right here. If you take this pitch, you know it's strike three. If you swing, you might bounce into a double play ball. So the best he could have done was maybe foul that thing off, but instead, he comes up empty.
Here's Nelson Cruz now, and he tries to hold back on the swing, but I think it would have been ruled a strike anyway. It's ready now with the payoff pitch. Oh, and here's a fastball right down the middle of the plate that swung on and hit out to deep left field, and this one's not coming back. This is a long home run. A two-run dinger off the bat of Nelson Cruz. His second home run of the series as the Mariners have come back to tie things at two.
Pitcher's got to be thinking, how can I throw a pitch like that in this situation? That thing was so right down the middle, it absolutely got hammered, and he knew it as soon as he let go of it.
Exactly what he needed after his guys came back to tie the ball game. He's only one out away from a shutdown inning.
One. Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. On his way to second is Tulowitzki. And he will stroll in there standing with a two-out double. Franklin Gutierrez comes to the plate as we get started here in the bottom of the
fine for the time being.
And a changeup swung on and missed for the first down.
And that changeup's not really a pitch you can sit on with two strikes. Because if he gives you that fastball, you'll be an hour late on it. That's a great job of not showing that pitch until he was ready to punch.
Edwin Encarnacion will stand in again, but first we'll flash you back to the very first inning of the ballgame. And here you go, a solo home run that had him off and running early on. Line toward the gap in left center. And this inning starts with a solid base hit. Josh Donaldson will dig in now. He struck out and lined out in his first two at-bats. And down in the Mariner bullpen, it looks like a right-hander's up to throw. Saws him off here as this ball's popped into the air. And he'll steer clear of the flying debris to make the catch here for the first down. Justin Smoke digs in. He was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Well, at the very least, he went down hacking. Striking out is one of the many frustrations that go along with hitting, and you have to accept that it's going to happen sometimes.
Now a ball lined toward the alley in left center. But this will hang up just enough as he takes it in stride in left center for the second out. Kevin Pillar will dig in. He doubled his last time.
And remember, he jumped all over that first pitch. So don't be...
That is really low for this stage of the game. And it's because he's throwing strikes and challenging guys.
And he tries for the backhand reach at third. But it gets by the glove down the line. Doubt.
The batter number four, shortstop.
Ketel Marte will stand in now. Hit high and deep to straightaway right field. Back goes Bautista, but he can't get to this one. It's off the wall. A leap at the wall, but he can't bring this one back. It's a home run. A solo shot here to straightaway right field. His first homer so far in the series. And with it, the Mariners move out in front 3-2.
Well, so much for that six in a row he's retired. That guy just says, take that.
Here comes a Toronto skipper out toward the pitcher's mound. And that will mean the end of the knuckleball here, as that's going to be it for R.A. Dickey. So he'll depart after 5 1/3 innings of work and with no shot to win the decision. Aaron Sanchez will be the new pitcher.
For the Blue Jays, number 41, Aaron Sanchez.
Now Cano swings and misses on a good two-strike pitch there as he's retired for out number two.
Nothing better for your confidence than to come right in out of the bullpen and strike that first guy out. A lot of times, that'll set the tone for your whole outing.
Nelson Cruz will stand in again as we flash you back here to the fourth inning. This was a two-run home run that was definitely one of the big swing to keep it going. And he looks at one that misses, and that's an excellent job of making his man throw a lot of pitches. Welcome back to Safeco Field here in Seattle. Game four is off to the seventh inning now, but before we get it started, let's check out our game summary to this point. Kyle Seager will dig in now. He's lined out. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out.
And this is a big inning here. You're down only one with the heart of the order coming up next time you get in, so that's a good first step.
So one gone now. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and it's one and two. Oh, and there's the good curveball as he's set down on strikes for the second time here tonight.
And sometimes up there you just get completely fooled. I mean, I think he changed his mind about swinging at this pitch about three different times while it was on its way to the plate. I'm going to swing. No. I'm going to take it. Oh, well, I better try to at least.
But indeed in the strike zone for the first strike. Hold back here. It's one and two. Swing and a miss. Blew the fastball right by him, and the inning is over. Three up, three down, three strikeouts. Not too shabby. Back with more of game four. Leading off the inning, Jose Bautista, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up.
Well, it's a close ball game, but it's starting
to the windup. Here comes the 0-1. Left side of the infield into the shift. He gets dirty, but he can't make the play. It's a base hit.
The batter, number 10.
Here comes the Seattle skipper on his way to the mound, and he's going to motion for his bullpen here. That'll do it for the starter tonight. So he'll depart with the lead and a chance to be the winner, but he is responsible for the tying run at first. Nick Vincent is on to work as he'll take over here in the eighth.
Number 50. Nick Benson.
Time called here, as with the potential tying run aboard, they'll make the move to get a little more speed out there. Ezekiel Carrera will stick around as he'll take over in right field.
Now playing right field, number 3.
Set down, one away.
Now batting.
Leonis Martin will stand in, and they've done a good job keeping him off base at the top of the lineup. He's 0 for 3 thus far.
But you've got to know your scouting report, because this is a guy that can cover the outside part of the plate.
And a fastball blew it right by him, and there are two down.
Well, you're always gunning for a strikeout when he's at the plate because his legs make him so dangerous, even when he hits just a slow grounder. So nice job of keeping him off base right there.
Into the box now. Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. 1-2-3 go the Mariners, and it remains a 3-2 ball game. Steve Cishek is on now to try to close things down here in the ninth.
Number 31, Steve Cishek.
Striding in to start the ninth, Justin Smoke, and they'll need him to get something going here.
Well, this has been a great game so far, and they're only down by one, so getting this leadoff guy on would be huge for them.
This is line to left, and a great start to the ninth, as this ought to be extra bases. Head down through first. He's heading for two. And he'll get in at second base as the tying runs aboard with a leadoff double.
Center fielder,
Deyonder Navarro, step in now in a big spot here in a game as close as this one.
And a chance at redemption, too, because he hasn't done much through his first three plate appearances. He could make up for all of that with a base hit right here.
Shatters the bat as this is hit on the ground. Throw on to first, and now the Jays are down to their final out. So striding in, Devin Travis, as he's got a chance to tie this ball game up with that equalizing run just 90 feet away at third. And he struck him out, and the ball game is over as they get the possible tying run over to third, but can't get him across.
Yeah, and you know this home crowd is going to get to drive home happy as their guys come through with a very good win.
This one, definitely a low-scoring affair as we get one last look at our final line score. Guys, if you're going to be successful in the postseason, as you know, you need players coming up big, and this guy certainly did that. He's our top player of the game.
Yeah, no time like the postseason to come through and prove your mettle. I think his performance here was by far the big key to this ballgame.